Tonight, 10 Investigates uncovers another story of what happens when children end up caught in the cycle of foster care. And this next story will illustrate how life can change in an instant.
We're about to closely examine one incident, one fatal crash, and its connections to the foster care system. Here's Chief Investigative Reporter Bennett Haberly with the gaps he's uncovered.
449, I got one out. He's in bad shape. We're working on trying to get the other one out. Vehicle's on fire.
In an instant, life can change. This crash on No Bixby Road last October is evidence of that.
447, tell fire to step it up.
It happened in the moments after a Madison Township police officer tried to pull over this Mercedes and the 15-year-old driver behind the wheel.
Stay calm, buddy, okay? Your leg?
Yes.
Anywhere else?
No, it's okay. My leg.
Put your hands on your chest like this. There you go. Just stay calm. Stay calm, buddy.
Moments earlier, a 911 call from a foster parent.
I didn't report a stolen car just now. He's an autism kid, disabled. He is 15 years old. It's a blue Mercedes.
Ma'am, stay with me, okay?
4145 on scene, 41 Black and Chatterton.
Stay with me.
In an instant, lives changed forever.
I miss her very, very much.
Tonda Shaw lost her mother, Paula Kennedy, in that crash. The Groveport Madison school secretary died alongside her dog. Tonda's father had passed away weeks earlier.
Now, my children have absolutely no grandparents. That's really hard. It's incredibly stressful.
But 10 Investigates has learned this wasn't the first time the teen was caught driving illegally.
Has he done this before?
Yes, with another foster parent.
This fatal crash marked the third time the 15-year-old had driven illegally within the past year. The first instance happened in January of 2021, when the then 14-year-old was charged by Worthington police with criminal damaging, accused of driving a GMC SUV through the soccer field of a school. Juvenile court declared him delinquent, but that case was dismissed by late June. 2 months later, another case, grand theft of a motor vehicle, a Dodge minivan, allegedly stolen from this foster home in Dayton. Images you can see on Google Street View. Columbus police recovered it at a gas station on Fifth Avenue here in Columbus. But the teen wasn't charged with that case until October 22nd, leaving a gap where no charges were filed, meaning he wasn't placed in juvenile detention, but in another foster home. And 12 days after that minivan was reported stolen, the teen is accused of taking this Mercedes, which ends in that fatal crash. 10 Investigates also found this, a series of police reports dating back 3 years to the teen's foster home for complaints about missing persons, stolen cars, and domestic violence.
They fell short. That child, it wasn't that kid's first time in Children's Services care. He was 15. It was their job to make sure that he was safe and anybody who could have been around him were safe, and they did not.
We wanted to know how often this happens, where a child in the care of Franklin County Children's Services is involved in an incident that claims another life. A spokeswoman for the agency said she couldn't tell us because they don't track it.
There may be some people who see this and look at it and say, Franklin County Children's Services has a tough job. Is it fair to blame them?
They do have a tough job. However, that's their job. That is their job. To make sure, you know, if they deem a child or children not safe in a home, it is their job to make sure that they are safe and they're put in a safe situation and that people around them are okay and safe.
It is important to point out, 7 months later, no one has been charged in connection to that crash. Columbus police tell me it is still under investigation. The teen's mother declined our request for an interview. Tonda, by the way, tells me that her mother's legacy continues. 9 Groveport Madison students earned scholarships last night in her honor. Franklin County Children's Services has said it cannot discuss individual cases. In our next report, we'll look at another issue, foster placements inside behavioral treatment centers. That's tomorrow night at 6. Yolanda?